Hey, Reject Nation, I'm the G-Alba. This is the J-Alba. We are going to watch The Bad Times, not the. Sorry, Schmodown fans. A lot of people have sent a request for this. This is Drew Goddard's next movie. Let's give a Patron of the Day shout out to James Stakins.
Jimbo Stakes.
I wanted to give a shout out to James Stakins because he has quite a gay man crush on the Chris Hemsworth. And Chris Hemsworth, shirtless and a mustache, you know Stakins is going to town on himself Stakins right now.
Salivating.
Watching this trailer. If he was at the El Royale with Chris Hemsworth, man, oh man, they would have to retitle this. Yes. At least let me finish the sentence and then you insert the punchline. You can't just overlap the punchline.
Everybody back to one.
We're making a joke about James Stakins wanting, you know what? I'm sorry, James. Put a stake in it, John.
Put a stake in it.
Ooh. The El Royale is a bi-state establishment.
You Jeff have the option Bridges. To choose
a room in either California
John
or
Ham.
Nevada.
Yeah. How'd you end up at the El Royale?
The Ritz-Carlton was booked.
This place used to be hustling and bustling. Old Dean Martin even sang a song about it once.
This is not a place for a priest, Father. You shouldn't be here.
We might need to work on your sales pitch, son. The El Royale. No place for a priest.
Whoa! That's the one to quote him on. There are a lot of other movies. Damn.
Whoa.
What the hell?
Whoa. You watch me? I only watch who they tell me to watch.
Who's they?
Management.
Would you mind opening up the door?
No, I ain't gonna do that.
Oh.
Get as far away from him as possible.
Howdy. That was Dakota Johnson.
Yeah.
Dope.
I'm not really a priest.
Yeah. No shit.
Michael Giacchino.
Damn,
nice. That looks great.
Yeah,
that looks
seriously.
Great. Fun pacing with a horror element, suspenseful vibe to it. This is the director of Cabin in the Woods,
yeah,
right here.
Yeah, for sure. Well, I really liked, actually, the reversal that the tone went through in this trailer, because sometimes you can tell that the tone's going to switch, and I thought the way that they set this up was really nice, because I didn't really know anything about this going in.
I wasn't expecting it to get so dark and like horror movie-like.
And so gleefully imposing or threatening in the vibe, you know?
This is a great trailer. I'm really hoping the movie is as cool as the trailer.
If the movie feels like this, I'll be pretty excited.
And if it has a cool, like, tonal build to that. If there's one thing Drew Goddard's gonna do, and it's taking an ensemble of characters, Cabin in the Woods, same thing, an ensemble of characters, people slowly start getting picked off. You know?
This almost reminded me of Identity because of that.
Oh, yeah, like the rain,
the
hotel.
Rain, the hotel.
Yeah, definitely.
Just in the aesthetic. This looks like it's gonna be really fun to watch all these actors interact together and show the two sides of each of their characters, you know?
Well, that's what he's gonna do, and it's fun and suspense
simultaneously
blended together. Oh, yeah, I've heard about this. It's Chris Hemsworth with the mustache.
Yeah.
He's barely in the trailer.
And partway through the trailer, I was like, is he going to be in this trailer?
Yeah.
Like, where'd that shot come
from? Looks like he's the main antagonist. See Chris Hemsworth as a bad guy who's having fun.
Yeah, I'm excited.
That sounds really fun. That sounds really cool.
Yeah.
I would much rather prefer that over him being one of the good guys in the movie.
Yeah,
if
definitely.
Anything, I feel like most movies might have, like, role-reversed this a little bit. I don't think Chris Hemsworth would be the priest, but I feel like Jeff Bridges might have been the bad guy. Jeff Bridges does not seem to be doing the
Jeff Bridges with the king.
I'm not a priest.
Well,
bad times.
Well.
Yeah, it's cool to see him really show his range.
Yeah. Subtle. Yeah.
Definitely. I like it.
And John Hamm in like this kind of era, totally different. You would have never suspected. Like, I've always said John Hamm would be the perfect actor to put in another era. And yeah. I'm surprised they've never done that with John Hamm.
Yeah, it's really inspired to see, you know, like,
Risks.
Props to Drew Goddard for inventing that combination.
I mean, this whole cast looks hot and spicy, John.
That's one way to... Muy caliente.
Cynthia Erivo looks like she'll probably be the standout.
Yeah, steal the show.
I feel like she'll be the last woman standing, or last human standing. I don't want to say last man standing to not upset anyone, especially the way the trailer ended. And she's in Widows too, so this is gonna be her year.
Off right
this
now,
is
yeah.
gonna be her year, man. I like that it's called Bad Times at the El Royale because it kind of has this like Western Mexican standoff vibe about it.
Yeah, totally. Well, any trailer that can hook me like this and make me wonder what on earth this is gonna be about, but still looks like it's gonna be a really solid, good time. Like that's a good teaser, right?
Yeah, man. This looks like good alcohol, no time required. Drew Goddard's work on all of J.J. Abrams' material.
Like everything in the Buffyverse.
To do stuff with people like Joss Whedon and J.J. Abrams. Joss Whedon, who can bring a lot of fun and nuance with his characters.
And a lot of deconstruction.
Yeah, and then also having J.J. Abrams, who has the cool mystery building up element. That's the thing that Drew Goddard, he has both
the
plates.
Perfect middle ground between those two.
And having this in this one movie, that'd be sweet. That'd be excellent.
Yeah.
And he wrote World War Z, which had the best behind-the-scenes production story ever.
100%, man.
All right, guys. Well, what do you guys think of Bad Times at the El Portal Theater? You guys can go check out the Schmodowns September 8th. Subscribe to the Reject Nation. Click that notification bell. The subscribe buttons don't really work. Seriously, you should check out the latest updates on subscribe buttons. And you should check out our Patreon. And you should get a gun and shoot that guy on the bike because he's trying to show us how big his penis is. Which it is. I saw it. It's huge. So
that's why it makes that noise. It gets caught in the exhaust pipe and it like flaps against the side and creates this vibration. You
know? I've never been there.